So he went and they'll take off.
Recording.
Yeah. We are essentially three lines from the bottom on page Kuf Samach, Kuf Membov. The line begins with Yivachayi Echad. Essentially, this is just a conclusion of what we already discussed. The principle that we're discussing is that yesh is rooted in Oir HaSoiviv, not in Oir HaMemale, although it comes through the Memale, because there's a whole array of things that are created. But the yesh element is from the Soiviv. And the Rebbe brings down, he says, I guess, Akedosh, in Tanya, Yivachayi Echad, Vezel Hasheni, and here's a quote. And he says over there, Vegam, and so too, Me'el, and Yisoyev, HaSeiv, and Makiv. From the Oyer Yisoyev, HaSeiv, and Makiv, and Dalad Eilmas, that encompasses, and is above, and surrounds, and encompasses the four worlds, Abiyah, Atimus, Bri, Yitzir, Asira, B'shove, this is the oil that is Asoiviv, that is the supreme oil, that encompasses all four worlds equally. From the perspective of this oil, El Atzilus and Bri and Asiya are equal. Because this is not world, this is Elokus itself. So from this oil, Meir El Hakav Hapnimi, Meir, it protrudes out and it illuminates and it empowers from it to the Kav Apnimi, to the Kav, which is the thin line of Elokus that is drawn after the Tzimtzum, Hapnimi, that is essentially Pnimi, that has a Pnimi, an internalizable. Intent. Then Hakadim, the Yisfiras, the Biya. By the services of the Kadim of the Yisfiras, the Biya, Ubaharose te Hakadim, and Baharose. As a result of this shine, they hakelim into the kelim, noisim bahem, it provides in the kelim, koyach ve'oiz, it provides in the kelim the power, libra yesh miyayim, to create yesh miyayim, ad kan Hashem. So bottom line, the creation of yesh miyayin, as it manifests itself, it comes through the keli. As we mentioned before, that the yesh miyayin is not a soiviv type of a presence. It is a specific. It's a pnimi type of a presence. But this pnimi type of presence is empowered by the to be able to create yesh miyayin. And for the purposes of this discussion here, that will conclude. Therefore, we see there that the yesh is from the Eir HaSoiviv davka. This is what I promised to discuss yesterday.
This last point, yesh is from the earth side of Dafka, yeah? What you said?
No, yeah, that would be said. The point that I wanted to discuss, I left open yesterday. Actually, I put the question later on, I think through WhatsApp. Yesh is a blanket presence, seemingly without any ruchnius, any sense. It's a yesh, it speaks for itself only. How is that a contributor, to the world in general, or to avoid it, to life? Seems to be a disinterested presence. Where is the message in this yesh that connects the world and connects us to the creator of this yesh? If yesh is such a stalwart, so to speak, a standalone entity, that's what yesh mei ayin. Seems to be implying. So I thought a lot how to present the following concept. Clearly, it must be understood that this yesh is not meant to hide and to dissociate us from the Creator. The exact opposite is true. He created such a reality in the world that should connect us to the Creator in a more powerful and a more direct way than any other way. To create a yesh, a miraculous entity, to dissociate the world from Abishan, that clearly is not in the cards, that's not the purpose. So here is an approach that I thought would give us a means to think into it and to recognize something beyond the surface. And then it opens up a completely different perspective. Okay? This we all know from the Mendel Futterfass, also. Mendel Futterfass came back from Siberia, where he spent many years. And then he met many all kinds of different people. Amongst them was a tightrope walker. The Russians sent all their talents away to Siberia. They were scared. They were scared of talented people. Because talented people understand, by the way, the lies that you're presenting. So they would send them away.
So you what?
I didn't. They'd send them away for re-education, yeah?
Well, they just send them away.
To get rid of
Siberia. So he met all kinds of people, and this was a talented tightrope walker. and demonstrated his strength, his skill, and all that. And he explained to Mendel Feuerbach's model and repeated that. Very important insight. He says that the rope that you're walking on is attached to two poles and two ends. These poles protrude out above the rope. As you're walking on the rope, you have to focus very intently on the pole in front of you. This focus on the pole, this is what gives you balance. If you distract yourself, look away from the pole, you're liable to fall down. So in addition to the physical skill and the balance on the feet and so forth, there has to be the ability of focus and concentration onto this pole. This is a phenomenal message, lesson. The yesh of the world is like this pole that is there, a standalone reality, and it's a constant reminder, a constant empowerment. There is a reality right around you at your level. This physical presence, I'll be explaining, this physical presence is representing the power behind it is an oil makif, the supreme oil, oil asayif. It's a miraculous representation. And it presents this miracle in the simplest and most concrete, the most worldly level possible. On a physical level. So that in this physical level, this physical orientation, this gives you a sense of solidity and balance in your world. And the solidity is, your Creator is with you all the time. This is what you it calls for. You don't have to go into in great insights to recognize the presence of the Creator. The Creator is there in front of you, just like in your eyes. This is what we explain all the time, is the principle of Chochmah. Chochmah sees what it sees. But this is why it's called Chochmah. It is the Behema also sees. What's the difference between the human sight and the Behema seeing? The human sight, the Chochmah is, it sees the fact that this physical presence is being presented to you. It is not that you discovered it from the physical orientation. It is being presented to you from the source of the creation, of this physical presence. This is how Chochmah sees. Chochmah sees that this physical entity is really a continuous creation. A continuous creation from Oyer HaSebe and Amakif. From Atzmus itself. It's a constant reminder and provider for continued balance within the world of the Creator Himself. Thus, this physical entity, on the one hand, is devoid of any ruchnius. On the other hand, it is totally representative of the source of sources. And that is what it's meant for. This is like the pole on the tightrope, on the edge of the tightrope.
Oh, sorry.
It is not only to hold up the rope. It is to give you a balance to enable you to walk through the rope. It is to hold up your arm, able to walk through the world. And keep your balance in the world. And recognize your place in the world and your function in the world. Going back to the quote from Tanya, Alter Rebbe says this following, this quote, by the way, was made extremely famous by this song that they actually came from the, not from the Babichir, from the Satmar, I think. Vini Hashem Oymidolo, behold, this is the contemplation that the Beinani has. He is concerned about where he is and what he is. Vini Hashem, behold, Hashem Oymidolo is standing over him. Umlei kol oros kvedei. And his comment, his glory is full everywhere. You don't have to look for him. This is the reality itself. Umlei kol oros kvedei. Umabidolo, and he is observing him. Ubechen klois v'leiv, and he's judging, and his internal goings on. Does this human being that I'm now relating to, does he have me in mind at all? Does he recognize that I'm there? In other words, this whole phenomenon that we recognize that God, the God, the divine presence, is not initiated by us, it's initiated by God Himself. And He creates, on a constant basis, the constant reminder that He is there, standing over us. Because as we said, yesh is a direct reminder, direct representation of the higher, of the Creator Himself.
It might seem like that is a very that's a very high perspective. Namely, I think it was one of our Rebbeim, when he was passing, he was looking at the ceiling, he could see how it was being created every moment. Here we're sort of saying it's open, it's available to Chochmah, to know how, see how the world is being presented.
There are different, clearly there will be different insights, different degrees to which we understand it. But just as the tightrope walker saw in this pole a balancing source, it's a pole. But the pole is stationed solidly in the ground, and it gives him a sense of the straightness and, you know, where he stands, and gives him balance.
So to
the world, in the physical reality, is a constant balancing source.
because it's not about itself, but about the permanence of the creator.
That's right.
And why, I mean, one may think, and many people do think, in worldly terms. If I have a bigger house, I have more. If I have more money, I have more security. I mean, here we're saying no. This worldly stuff is really about him.
So, this is what we said. This is why so you have to talk about it.
Mm.
People lose sight. Just like the tightrope walker, he thinks that the rope is holding him up. He'll fall down.
Okay. Huh. I got it. He looks to what's beyond his rope. Mm-hmm. Okay. So too, man looks to beyond what his real estate.
What's holding
is.
It up? What is it? Yes. What is this? All right. Okay, so now we're at the bottom of page Kuf Membov, the last few words. We were here for quite some time, and ultimately, what we walk away with from this is that the Yesh is actually representative of the Oyin and Soif HaSoibim. And then it comes into world, into Atzilus, and it results in Kelim. That Kelim are those aspects that contain and represent and bring the Pnimi aspect of the Oyer, not the Mesoyer. But we're saying that even though it goes to the Kelim, the Koyach and the message that it carries is the Oyer HaSoiviv. And now we're going to go conclude this inside. The last few words on that page. V'hagam, although, Shebderech Klal, pardon me, that in a very general perspective, Atzilus, who became a soibib. Atzilus is an aspect of soibib legabe biya, relative to biya. Even though in Atzilus there are kelim, but if you compare Atzilus to biya, Atzilus is super. It's not a world. It's super worldly. Excuse me. It's a soibib. In other words, it is pure oyer, and the kelim there are almost oblivious, non-existent, even though there are kelim. But the kelim are completely transparent to the oyer. So relative to biya, tzil, this is what we say all the time, I just want to remind us. There are four worlds, atzilus, briyati, and asiya. There is a significance in the names of these worlds. But the word Bria means creation. Creation means creation. Yesh Miyah, you create something that wasn't there before. And now, Atzilus is not called a Bria, not called creation. Atzilus means emanation. Emanation means that it emanates that which is there already at a higher level, now it emanates and reveals itself. That's essentially what emanation is. So Atzilus is not a real creation. But yet, it is Oyin Keli, and Keli means it's a creation.
It's still called Oyla.
What?
It's still called the
Oilam. That's right, but how come it's called Oilam? Because it has these kelim. I want to elaborate on the Kalim principle. As I said, we already discussed this a lot. The principle of the Kalim versus the Oir, the Oir is of the Oir and Kalim, this is what constitutes the world. But the difference is, the Oir is representing the source, Kalim represents the world in which it emanates. Just like we said many times, you make a keli, make a cup. In order to have a cup, you have to take a material that already exists, that is tangible and solid in the world, in the world itself. You take something from the world to make the keli. Keli begins from the world level, and then the oil illuminates it.
We had this upside down a moment ago, right? That worldly stuff and Kalim, etc., are truly like the pole. They indicate him.
That's right.
His presence. Now we're.
No, we're not going nothing. So what is the pole made of?
So it is made of chomer.
Huh?
Chomer, materiality.
That's right. If the pole were a suggestive, a ruchnis gepoldi, wouldn't give you the balance. It's a world because it's oir bekeili. And the principle of oir bekeili, again, please follow this. Oir bekeili means that you take something that pre-exists, that is really of the world material, and you imbue it into it an oir that from a higher level. Just as we talk about seichel. Seichel is on the shama inyan. And how do you express, how do you bring out the seichel? You express it in words, physical words, that exists independently of the seichel. But you formulate them in a certain way that they represent the seichel. And only a bar seichel, somebody who applies himself to these words, he can see the seichel that these words carry. You can't carry seichel directly, from person to person. You have to carry it through the means of that of the world, of the sounds of the words. These words have nothing to do with the seichel in itself. These words are actually entities within the world, and that's why we can communicate. We can talk about the seichel that we haven't yet understood, but we use the kelim, we use the means by which is present that we all recognize. And then we delve into the kelim, we form the kelim in a certain way that we can derive from that the seichel that it is intended to be brought through. This is what kelim is. So the phenomenon of kelim is that you descend down to the place, to the world, and there you express something which is super higher than this world. Using the Kalim. Now the oil that's in Atzilus is a higher oil, it's already coming from Keser. This is what he said at the end of that line.
This is where we started, what line are we
in? The last few words on that line.
Which line?
On the last line on Pukum Mechaz, Membom.
That's where we started today?
Yep. Mehagam shem derech klal Atzilus. Ho bichines sebe v'legam b'biya. Atzilus, from a very general perspective, Atzilus is an aspect, is a sebe of quality relative to b'biya. Meaning it is a quality that is super worldly from the Biyah perspective. Biyah is a creation a new creation. Atzilus is not a creation. Atzilus is emanation. Atzilus alludes back to Keser, to that which is higher than world. Like you always say, Chochma. Atzilus is the Madrig of Chochma. Bia, Biribi is the Madrig of Bina. So even though Atzilus, Bederach Klal, is Soivim, Lagabe Bia, Velatim, Mikol Mokoim, continue on the page Kuf Mem Zayin. Mekom Mokoim, but still, Habiprotius Amadreges. When you go into the details of the Madreges within Atzilus itself, Hareze Bechinas Oipnimi. It is the Bechina, it is the aspect of Oipnimi. Oipnimi means an internal, rather than a seiver, than a makif. Pnimi means that it is in full balance and in full recognition and acceptability within the world arena. That's mean pnimi. So even though, in general, Atzilus is a higher quality than Bia, than world, than Bia, seiver. But when you go down to the protim, the protism there is, in detail, the various qualities that Atzilus represents in the Kelim, it is the Bechina of Epnim. What this means is the following. Atzilus is an oyer coming from a higher source. And just, and we'll use the most of a human being, just like Seichel is an oir coming from a neshama oir, coming from Rotson and Oinig, as we discussed recently and lately. But then, in order to be presented within the worldly context, it is minimized to the point where you can actually express it in words. In Kelim. You cannot present in Kelim, in words, your feeling of Ahava and Yira, or your Oinag and Rotzen. As much as we struggle, explaining Rotzen is no way. It is not tangible. But once you go into Chochmah, in Seichel, you present the Seichel in the Kelim in words. So, Biprotes and Madreyes, Atzilus, when you go down to the specifics of Atzilus, it is the beginning of Eipnimi. It is in the category of Eipnimi. An Eipnimi, Eipnimi means that it internalizes and it is part of the world rather than being a Soivik. It's of a worldly quality than a savior. And this is why it goes through Keli. Each Keli represents a different oil. This is what we're saying, that there is in Hayesh in Atzilus, in Kelim. Even though Atzilus per se is higher than Yesh, higher than creation, it's an emanation. But then specifically it goes into a Kelim and become, and now it represents its Oir on a worldly level. Let us take it back into our Moshe. Let's compare the following. I have a cup of water. When I give you the cup, you can take the cup without even contemplating as to what's in it, then what do you do with it? You take it via the cup and you have the water. If you hear a seichel in words, despite the fact that it's given to you in words, you still don't have the seichel. You don't have to decipher the words, and you have to delve into it and get, and what's the message? What's the message that's containing these words?
You have to drink it.
What?
You have to drink it.
You have to drink it. What's the message?